Look, this week we need to spread a little Christmas cheer around this place, right, Rock? We've had a good year. Rocco, make sure the fire chief gets a little extra something something in his envelope, okay, Rock? Even if it feels like there's no more room, that you can't put any more into the envelope, squeeze a few more C notes in there. Maximum occupancy, Rocco. Make sure that's a full fucking envelope for him. The guy that makes Cocoa Puff happen happens to need a new muffler this year, Sal. So make sure you talk to Yakabuchi's cousin who owns the shop on Euclid. And make sure that this guy gets the dual exhaust, huh? Bobby, those two guys from Murray Hill Cement that always give us an extra truck of concrete exactly when we need it. Make sure they get a nice envelope. And maybe some shoes. Whatever shoes they want. Amber shoes, Tiffany shoes, crystal shoes. Look, I'm not into that, but to each his own. The guy that gets us tickets to the Browns, tickets to the Indians, tickets to the Coliseum, Jimmy Snake Eyes, he's building a new house. So this year, he gets a backstage pass, which means before those 2x4s get to the supply house, the truck stops at his site. Sal, I know you want to hand out envelopes too because it's Christmas, but can I trust you, Sal? How about last year? Police Chief McKibben, $1,000? Where'd you get that fucking number, huh, Sal? Cookie told you 500. Did you see the list? You check it twice. That's what you're supposed to do, Sal. You don't just come up with a fucking number out of thin air and go, oh, I want to be good. I want to spread some fucking cheer. Uncle Paul tells Cookie how much to give. Do you think the police chief was surprised? Yeah, he don't deserve $1,000. He's not even Italian. And then what? He treats us like shit all fucking year? You want to be the fucking Santa? Give him a pet rock on top of the bonus. Just like you, Ronnie. Who told you to give the paperboy $50, huh? How many times I gotta tell you, my Uncle Paul don't get the paper. Jimmy from next door gives him his paper, okay? He doesn't get the paper delivered. You need to go back to that paper boy and get that 50 spot. And don't forget, Rocco, we gotta take care of those two Slovenian meter maids, the girls from downtown. Every time we park the Riv illegally in front of the courthouse, waiting for you, they never give us any headache, especially Helga. She just walks over, pops a few buttons. What are you boys doing here again? We're waiting for Rocco. Oh, can I get you something? Can I put a quarter in the meter? It'll get you 2 hours. Nah, we're good, Helga. How about a hot dog, a Sprite, or maybe I could get you a Slurpee. This is the kind of women that I want in my life. Don't you understand that, Rocco? We need to bring them bags and bags of quarters. A quarter for 2 hours? This is the best deal in town, Rock. Frankie, make sure that Father Bucala gets at least 2 cases of Uncle Paul's homemade wine. We gotta stay in his good graces, all right, Frank? This year we're gonna be running the concession during the feast in the church basement. The over-under, the raffle, the $10,000, by the way, will be going to Mrs. Ian Marino, like every year. This time she wants to put a sunroom on the back of the house. We got that job, so she wins. Plus, Father always has our back. Every time Grandma says, did you see my boys at church? He's so cool. He's like, yeah, there's some in the back. There we're there. This guy doesn't crack. You never see him sweat. The one time I saw him lose it is when Amber from the Crazy Horse came out of the confessional. That's the only time I seen him panic. He made the sign of the cross like 4 times. Those two mooks, Frankie, the bookies that we put in a hold this year because they can't figure out numbers, send them some ketchup. Some Italian ketchup from Sodari's to let them know that next year there'll be more blood in the streets. Because last year you fucked up, Ronnie. This year you're gonna buy my grandma a new manger scene, you understand? A traditional manger scene. Jesus in swaddling clothing. She wants the Virgin Mary, the real Madonna. Not the one that sings like a virgin, Ronnie. You can't buy religious items at Spencer's, you understand? Looks like we're gonna need about 20 Cabbage Patch dolls. We got 10. So what we're gonna do is take the Cabbage Patches out of the boxes and put in those fucking Teddy Ruxpins that you got sell that nobody fucking wants into the box, go back to Sears and tell them they fucked up, okay? My uncle needs a 12-foot Christmas tree for the house at Pepper Pike. He needs an 8-foot Christmas tree for the house on Monticello. And he needs a 4-fucking-foot Christmas tree to shove up the ass of fat fucking Tony Catalano for trying to take that bathroom job at Hallard's Lincoln Mercury. Some mook at the mall dressed like Santa put his hands on Amber's ass when she was off duty from the Crazy Horse. We gotta do something about it. But first, we gotta find out if this is a Santa of ours or an out-of-town Santa. If this is a made Santa, we're gonna have to get permission from the guys up north. If not, we put them in a box and we ship them to the South Pole. One of the out-of-town parishioners bought a box of Aunt Patty's potsales at the church bake sale and watched him throw the box in the garbage can. She would like us to find this man and return the potsales, but also asked us if we could guarantee that he could never taste them. And don't forget about the Crazy Horse's Secret Santa, which I think all of you are involved, except Rocco. Because, of course, his gift is hard to hide. Right, Rock? Especially when he hangs mistletoe off it.